Okay, the screen is visible to you.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So I formally welcome you people for public relation class, right? Module 5. Okay. So see, anyway, we people have dealt with all the 4 modules, and the last module where we people have discussed on keeping a good relationship with the community, right? So PR and community relationship, that is what we people have discussed into your previous class. Fine. In the in this class of your module 5 and part 1, it will take around 2 classes to get completed. Fine. In this module, we people are going to have concepts on media relationships, few basic things about the media, and the related activities when we people are going to keep a relationship with them, okay, as a PR professionals, right? So here we go one by one, right? Media relations module 5, which purely talks about how an organization is going to keep a relationship with the journalist, or say any person who is going to represent one or the other media. Okay, and how we people are going to keep a relationship with them, it matters a lot. Because if you just recall your initial classes when we people started this subject, we have been, came across certain concepts, is that, there must be a certain person who will be taking your message to the targeted audience, or say a public. Fine. So media plays a very important role, especially in taking your message to your a targeted audience or a public. And remember, as also been told to you people, that where people will be believing your message sometimes, into which type of media it has been broadcasted. If those people have belief in those medias, or maybe a journalist who will be working, okay, and getting some good information to those people, okay, if a journalist tells about a message, okay, whether it is positive or a negative, right? So both is going to be believed by a public or a targeted audience. So you have to have a good relationship with the media, and media plays a very dominant role when it comes to your public relation activities, right? So having your own media may not be much effective, okay, for the organization, right? So they have to go for asking a help from certain medias which will be broadcasting their programs and the related communication or a message which those people will be helping organization in transferring it to the related public, or say you can say it as a targeted audience. So this is what, now if you see now at the present scenario, if you're seeing, media plays a very, very important role. And if you find you are very well versed with that, and you know better that how many medias that are channels that we people can find. If you take one Hindi news channel, you'll get more than 10 or 20 channels which are today started and broadcasting a similar type of messages. But the way the message is going to be transferred, okay, how best those people are going to organize the message for the audience, on that basis their success or failure is going to be relying on. Fine. So we have next something like what we say as a media relation. So we say a meaning or definition, media relation, which refers to that the relationship that any company or say an organization is going to developing with the journalist. So there are some frontline employees, okay, that media services who is going to render. There are some frontline employees, especially those are a journalist who will be always having continuous touch with the current information and current happenings, where those people will be a dominant people who will be representing a media, and organization or say a company is going to develop a good relationship with them. So we say this as what? Basically we say a media relationship is what? A relationship which an organization or say or a company is going to develop with the journalist who are representing one or the other media channel, right? So, but one thing remember, where companies are also very good enough, once they keep a good relationship with the journalist, okay, journalist will take a message to a certain targeted audience on behalf of, say, the organization. But organizations are very clever, okay, the public relation departments or executives are very good, clever, you know, intelligent enough in taking something beyond just, you know, passing the message to the public. So journalists or say the media work is what? They set certain, you know, a channel where those people will make your message to reach your public or a target audience. But while public relation is going to extend that relationship beyond the media to the general public, say the whatever is been help taken by this media people, beyond that also a public relation is going to take it, okay, to meet its, you know, a general public. Then we have media relations is the ongoing, you know, felicitation and then coordination of communication also, and relation between an individuals, it may be a group or maybe organization or other, and a media. So this is something, it's ongoing. You cannot say that today some help, you know, and PR people or say organization takes it from a media people. So once it is done, it doesn't mean the relationship is going to come to the end. No, it is something, a continuous process, because a lot of information continuously which has to be furnished to the needy stakeholders of the organization. Okay, and for that, you know, in one or the other way, media plays a very vital role in taking that information to the targeted audience. So it's a continuous process, transfer of information, okay, and keeping good relationship with the media people. So there, the coordination is very much important between the individuals, an individual from the PR department or individual from the a media, like a journalist will be having a good relationship. Maybe a group of people, an organization will be having a good relationship with the media, right? So there are certain principles of media relationship that you people have to keep in the mind when you people want to keep a good relationship with the media. Okay, the relationship is both, you know, inevitable, we say. Excuse me. Okay. So, here are certain principles. The relationship is both inevitable for both the people, whether it is an organization or it's a media. It is a must. We say it is a necessary that both should have a good relationship, and you cannot, you know, come out of it. So there is no alternative for any organization except the media to reach their customers, right? Maybe there are a few, but not so effective than, you know, a media. What, you know, the media can give a service to the organization in transferring the information to the general public, right? Okay. And we have second one. The organization should publicly speak with the worldwide. Okay, now it's also a type of, you know, principle which organization need to have if they are using two or three type of, you know, medias to reach their their targeted audience or say public. So they should have only one voice if say the information which is going to be transferred, say information A, that information A should remain constant, okay, similar among all the medias which those people are using to reach their targeted audience. Fine. Then we have third one, the personal, the person, you know, closest to the situation should be the, you know, designated spokesperson. They say whenever you want to keep a good relationship with the media, there must be only one person who is responsible for, you know, handling the relationships of the media. So any activities related to the media work, that one person should be the, whole and soul, you know, responsible person for that. And he has to speak with the media. Right, so the designated or, you know, the related person, okay, he has to have single point of contact with the media. So media should have a single point of contact with the organization with only one person who is going to be responsible for that, right? And then the organization should look upon, you know, reporters as partners in reaching various publics rather than as enemies. So you should have a very good relationship with the reporters, the journalist. Because they are the people, as I told you, like a liaison officer or partner among your work, which will be giving lot of help to the organization in taking your message in a proper way, okay, which can be easily understood by the public, because reporters know how to write it, okay, and how to represent the message, which will be very comprehending to the general public, where they can easily understand it and also they can retain it for a longer time. So they are the people who are very expert in understanding the situation and understanding how best the message can be drafted and how best it can be communicated to the general public, because they know the pulse of the public, how they receive the information and how they organize the information in their mind, and they retain it for a longer time. Okay, and we have next the fifth one. The organization should consider itself accountable to all of its various publics, internal as well as external. So any problem can happen sometimes, though a media has helped you people in reaching information, sorry, in reaching your public or targeted audience with certain information. Any problems happen, you are not supposed to blame the media people. So complete accountability and the responsibility of, say, any problem happens, it's whole and sole responsibility of the organization. The organization take it in the on its shoulder, and it is going to be accountable for anything whichever happens in the public, okay, regarding their issues or say message which has been transferred, right? And anything which is a problem created internal into the organization as well as external, they have to see to it. You cannot blame the media people, right? So media is just a person or maybe an organization which is going to transfer your information to the public. So next we have the media. The organization should not be, expect to control the media agenda or their assessment of what is newsworthy. Now you cannot have control on a media. Now media are totally a free-handed people. Okay, they are totally a free bird, where they have their own rules, they have their own type of agenda. Okay, and you as the organization cannot control the media. To certain extent you can, certain extent, depends on the capability of the organization in the media. If those people, organization has some stake into the media, right, and probably that can be a situation where media people can listen to them. So if their media people are totally free from any boundings towards the organization, so now organization cannot control the media. So you have to keep in the mind that controlling media agenda is not so easy. Okay, and you shouldn't do that, and also cannot have an authority of assessing the media people on the basis of newsworthiness. You just send a message to them, how they do it, okay, there will be certain meetings, and how you tell them, how you convey them, what should be there, it all depends on you as an organization. Okay, then the media relations office should always be in the loop, up to date, we say, as I told you initially, where the message which is going to be transferred to the public, okay, with the help of the media, once it is done, it doesn't mean that it is over. So you should have continuous interaction with the media people for understanding, okay, what new things are going in the market. Accordingly, people can also help them in preparing their programs which can suit the execution procedure of the media people, right? And you should be always in the loop. We say up-to-date information should be always taken, okay, what are going to happen, you should be also having the knowledge about it. So we have media coverage is considerably more credible than the advertisement. It says media, that is why I told you, advertising is generally, we do it where targeted audience as well as non-target audience, both are going to watch it, right? But thing is, when it comes to the media, there are very specific type of medias which they have their own followers. If those followers are your targeted audience or a public, probably that will be more effective, okay, than the advertising. So this can reach like anything. The scope, if you see, the scope of reaching the general public is more in media rather than just advertising. Okay, any doubts that you people have? Any doubts that you people have? Any doubts? Am I audible to you?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so we go with your next slide, which talks about role of media in public relations. This is what we people are very, very well versed with that, and we have used almost all type of media for one or the other reason, right? And it's a very general thing which is been known to us, fine, and with a lot of experience even we also have, but we think, we say, like, you know, once we people go on discussing this, you people can recall your experience, okay, of using it, okay, using these things, right? So in the role of media in public relation are going to be described in the following, we say different type of medias, like, you know, newspapers we have, okay, newsletters we have, then magazines, radio, right, websites or wired services like internet or ethernets, right? Okay, so we go one by one, like when we talk about this newspapers, right now, especially in India, it's very widely accepted, and even till today, though there's a dominance of internet, right? So the technology which is going to get a faster news to the people, still Indians are very much inclined towards reading the newspapers in the morning. So till today, the newspapers are surviving, okay, into the country due to the wide acceptance of the readers in the India. So this is also one type of more effective one, which gives you lengthy information and complete concentration that any reader will be giving, okay, the subscriber of the newspaper, reader of the newspaper will be giving a lot of attention in reading. They enjoy reading the newspapers throughout the day whenever those people get a time, okay. And very effective one also to use into the public relation, because if you see, before any event happens, or for example, like, you know, even at the time of the admissions, which is going to happen, like for example, like, you know, once the, you know, your UG exams are over, and PG institutions will be giving lot of write-ups about their institutions in the newspaper. One full page of the newspaper will be sometimes paid and utilized in showing or giving complete information about the history of the institution, right, their achievements of the institutions, the diversity of the institutions, right, okay, and the ranks, or it may be the placements. So almost all the information they type, and the people who are very much interested to go for PG courses, they go on reading it. And sometimes what happens, this can be collected and kept as a record, right? One can be collected and kept as a record, and for the future references, it can be also used. So somewhere it's a very effective one, okay, keeping a lot of interest, how you write into the newspaper, right? And how best the articles come into the newspaper, which will create attention, interest among the readers, okay, and holding it into the mind of the readers for a longer time, and those readers are going to discuss that with the others in their social groups. Okay, then we have newspaper like providing, it's provide ongoing news, you people get up to date coverage of any local news, or maybe a national news, or even international news or stories are going to be popping into those newspapers, which will give you almost all the information from politics till your entertainment. It talks about general knowledge, it gives you an information about, say, sports, right, so etc. Each section will be having its own importance in the newspaper, which gives you almost complete local news. Then you have a national news, and also you can find an international news also section into the newspapers, which can help you people to take a lot of knowledge. So somewhere, because of that, even adding PR activities, it can also help you people in covering, okay, all the concepts into the newspaper. Then we are placing story in a newspaper is a great way to reach potential volunteers. As I told you, the story which starts off an institution from its history, when it was started, from whom it was started, how many institutions are there, what is the present status, what is the future scope, for the future, prospect that those people are thinking of having. So these all things will generate an interest among the readers of a newspaper, right? And what we say, potential volunteers who are very much interested to go for PG courses. So those people read it completely, right? Then types of newspaper you have, like, you know, you have daily newspapers and weekly newspapers, right? Even sometimes we have a newspaper which comes in the evening also. What has happened? So fast those people are, right? Okay, now that was all about your newspapers. We have newsletters. Somewhere they are also similar to your newspapers, but not much wider in the scope how much newspapers are. Okay, now these are very excellent way of reaching a target audience. Not everybody is going to subscribe them or everybody is going to get it circulated. No, they are going to have if you have your own institution, and the institution can have its own newsletter. Okay, every 3 months institution can come with a newsletter stating that, you know, what has happened in all the 3 months, what events were conducted, what has happened, what grants has been sanctioned by the government, okay, what are the achievements of the institution. So those all things will come under 3 to 4 fold papers of newsletters, which will be circulated among the students, and sometimes it will be sent to the postal address of the students for their parents' references also. Even newsletters can be sent to some organization for placements, right? So these activities which an institution has conducted, its achievements, if it is known by the corporates, probably even that can help you people to boost into some other placement related activities or grant related activities. So they're very excellent way of reaching. This will be reaching only the targeted audience, not a general public. So use newsletters to share the stories of volunteers, report on social events, and also keep the community apprised of recent happenings within the program. So as I told you, what has happened currently, past what has happened, everything will be told to those people. And the newsletters are nothing but publications which are distributed on a regular basis among the target. These are regular. Sometimes newsletters comes monthly, they come into quarterly or sometime, or means what, 3 months once, half yearly, sometimes yearly also newspaper. Continuously it will be published and circulated among the targeted audience. Fine. Then public relation is experts collect complete information on their customers. So this is all the general thing which usually what we do is that people collect an information, right, and this will be circulated to the targeted audience or customers, what we say. Then we have next magazines, magazines like newspapers focus on the stories with a very detailed and fact-driven. We say especially magazines are very much concentrated on certain type of news. Okay, those news will be detailedly shared. So here in this, you get all details and related facts, okay, from where the information has been collected, fine, to boost the confidence and belief among the readers on the stories, whatever has been published into the newspaper. And often, report on a particular angle of the story that will be most interesting to the audience. So they make it very interesting to the audience in getting their interest in reading them, okay. Then magazines are important channels of communicating with the customers and investors and the community. So usually these magazines are published, okay, on certain time period, which will be circulated, okay, to the customers, the investors, as well as the community which is related to the organization. Right. Okay, we have certain radio, next newspaper, newsletters, magazines, and then we have a radio. This is very widely accepted nowadays, where people, especially in metros, you people can find too many radio channels with the different frequencies. People enjoy, okay, they use it for the entertainment purpose, because traveling is very high in metros. To reach their office, sometimes they take 1 hour, 2 hour time. For in between that 1 or 2 hour time, where a lot of radio stations will be publishing their frequencies. Where connecting to those frequencies via smartphones, they enjoy. Along with that, a lot of advertising can also happen on the radio, right? And even stories can be so nicely told by the radio jockeys about the organization and the related issues presently, what is happening. That leads to a discussion among them. Then, all form of media, there are more radio stations today than ever before, and most tailored, you know, their program to a specific audience. Some audience who are interested in news, some audience who are interested in, you know, music, okay, etc. Where those people, some are, you know, interested in education. So radios are having their own segments today. Now, irrespective of whatever segment, but still, any targeted audience who belongs to certain type of segments, probably those channels can be used by organizations in publishing or say communicating regarding their you know, public relation activities, okay, or information. Then websites, all the time you people are into that, and you people find that most of the media vehicles, websites are targeted towards a specific audience. Now certain websites we people, you know, follow on the basis of, you know, we find it as very authentic and the confidence which is being generated by those websites. Then we have wired services like your internet, or maybe it may be, you know, your say internet, what do people use, right? Wired services, broadband services, which will be a type of, you know, we say a media which will be helping you. Okay, the wires are the nerve center of the media. They typically, you know, compile stories from many different sources and post them for members, journalists use. Now these medias can also, you know, you can use the medias, post your information, journalists will be continuously going through it, and that can also help those people in, you know, collecting the information and making it as a story for their audiences. Fine, am I audible to you? Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So we have next, like, you know, some certain tools of media relations. You know, tools, we, these are things, press release we have. Okay, we have a press conference and social media. These two, press release or press conferences, usually we do with a journalist. Fine. Where press release, you people come with a story and you give that story to the media people, and those people will publish in their newspapers, okay, or any channel which those people use in reaching the general public. Press conferences can happen where in press release what happens, you just give a story and finish it off. But in press conferences, you people are going to call all the journalists from different channels or medias. Those people come and you people talk about the issue what you want to discuss with them, and that issue has to be or the information which you want your public to get it reached, and that information you are going to tell to the circulate among the you know, or communicate among, best is to communicate among the journalist people. And there will be n number of questions which the journalist will be asking for their own reference to get it cleared about your information. That all things should be cleared by the organization who has called for a press conference on the any issues. Okay, so once that is going to be cleared, discussion is over, then they will be publishing the same thing into their you know, newspapers or any other media or any type of media, right, news channels. Then we have the most very, you know, prominent one and widely used nowadays with almost all the age people, like social media. So before we go with what is social media, let us go with what is social then. Social is what? Interacting with other people by sharing and receiving information from them. It's a social life, you know, you people speak with the others, communicate with the others, and you know, you share certain information to the other people, and also you people will be having expectation to get information from those people. So you know, sending a message or, you know, sending information or receiving information, so this is what we say it as, you know, social with the others. Then we have media. It is an instrument of communication like the internet. Okay, where we use this media like a channel which we people want to transfer or communicate to the general public or say our targeted audience, right? Then we have social media or web-based communications. Now, what do we mean by social media? Like, these are web-based communication. We use technology here. Internet plays a very important role in connecting between the people. We're also helping them to interact with each other. Right? So this is what, you know, social media or web-based communication tools that makes the people, enables the people to interact with each other by, you know, sharing the information. Both are going to share the information, also consuming the information, means what, receiving the information and keeping that information with them for their present and the future references. Okay, these social medias are very active among the youths nowadays. And remember, the internet and the connecting devices what we have today making a social media very dominant one, and, you know, say a preferred one among the audience nowadays, the public, sorry. So we have some characteristics of social media. We go one by one, very easy. Now see, one characteristics of a social media is that, you know, participation, which will be encouraging the people who are using it. Okay, who are the part of, you know, that particular, you know, social media. Those people are going to be encouraged in contributing the information to the other needy people. Okay, and also it will help them to get a feedback from the others who have received the information from him or her. So it is something like, you know, participation very high, where some person sends a message, furnishes the information, and in the opposite side, where others who have received the information can also give a feedback to them, right? And the discussion starts. Openness, like, you know, as I told you, it's completely open. These type of social media service are very open in getting the feedback, also in participating, right? So this also helps in, you know, encouraging the participants and the participants in the social media for voting, then commenting on that, sharing the same information to others. So it's a very wider one when it comes to the scope. Then we have conversation, like, you know, whereas traditional media is about, you know, broadcast, especially when it comes to social media, it is better seen in two ways. So traditional media just send a message and over. There is nothing like, you know, two-way conversation or communication happens from the other side who has read the message. But in your social media, where both are going to interact, interacting with each other, and the conversation is very good. So community, when we serve the community, the social media allows a community to form quickly and, you know, communicate effectively. Even in social media, there are certain people who will be forming their own community of an interest, of a specific interest, where that will be discussed among them. Okay, then connectedness. Here, most kind of media thrives on their connectedness, making use of links to other sites and resources and people, where it is something like, you know, a network type of thing, where if I belong to one social network, okay, one, we have our own community, and this, some message has been, you know, communicated among my community. Probably I may be a member of other community also. The same, what I do is, now this community message I can also share among that particular community, where it was going to spread. Now that is what we said, connectedness among the communities for the information. The different types of social medias we have, like social networks we have, right? The services that allow connecting with the other people of similar interest and background, like, you know, Facebook and LinkedIn. Social networks, we say that, you know, like-minded people are going to come together and they're going to share, okay, some information and, you know, have a conversation with each other. Then we have book marketing sites, where free, services that allow our users to save, organize and manage the links to various websites and so resources around the internet, right? So somewhere we people use them, okay, in advertising better, where people, when they share the information, when they're retrieving, organizing, some one or the other type of, you know, information can be, you know, fixed in between those process, what those people are going to have in these book marketing sites. And social news, we have service that allow people to post various news items or say links to outside articles, and then allows its users to vote on the items. Even we have certain groups, in the form of social news, where they spread a news related to their interest, okay, and even that links can also be given to the others, outsiders, where they can open the link, read it and refer it, fine. Then we have media sharing, example like YouTube you have, and we have Flickr's, like service that allows the users to upload and share various media such as pictures and videos, right, where people, now if you have certain, you know, links with you, you can go through the links which has been provided by certain people on certain issues, which has been already recorded, and some pictures are shown for the reference of the people, interested people. Then we have micro blogging, services that focus on very shortest updates that are published out to anyone subscribed to receive the updates. Now for example, if somebody is into Twitter, that, you know, ongoing things you people can know, that what present updates are going to have, right? Anybody can tweet on certain issues, what updates those people have found, and others will be coming to know it. And we have some benefits of social media. As we say, it's very low cost, okay, it is very lowest cost because we also say sometimes very free of cost, because you just be a part of that particular social group, and one message you people are spreading in that, and that will be discussed, and also that will be getting connectedness with the other external bodies. Okay, and the amount what you people are spending is very, very less, and unlimited access, as I told you, where the business people, when they're using this, it is something accessible to almost everyone. So your targeted audience, it may be, or somebody who is not, even they can also access your information, they can receive the information, the same information can be even communicated to the needy people, okay, the target audience, something they can also help you people, right? And here doesn't matter any company size or turnover or context, so it's just a small organization can also use it, or even a bigger or larger organization can also use it. And it's very simple one, a basic knowledge which a general public is having in using the certain devices which are going to be connected with the social medias. Okay, the high level of skills, maybe a training as specialist equipment is involved in traditional media production, but especially when it comes to your the social media, it is no. Then we have reaching global reach. Like traditional media can reach a global audience, right? But this is usually very costly and time consuming, we say, especially traditional medias. Now social medias, in any corner people can receive your message, or you people can receive message from. And contact building, as I said, you know, it's like a networking, that you know, people go on listening to the information about the organization, they go on attaching to the social media which has been run by the organization. Then we have next one, like flexibility. You can change, you can modify your information, that you can circulate it, you can delete it, anything you can do it. Measurability is very good when it comes to social, you know, this media, right, where you can find the statistics immediately, how many people have liked it, how many have commented it. So getting a feedback so often can also help you people in measuring it. But traditional media takes a lot of time. Okay, have to do a lot of research, and then you people can find it. Okay, so this was all about your part one today. In the next class, we go with your working with the media. Any doubts that you people have? Any doubts you people have?